Whether you're a solopreneur, small business owner, or part of a medium-sized organization, I've created the perfect system for you within Notion to take your operations to the next level. My name is Ben, and I'm a four-time certified Salesforce consultant and the creator of the OptiOpp CRM. I've leaned on my years of CRM consulting to build the best Notion CRM available. This Notion CRM is being used by thousands of companies around the world to track revenue, collaborate with colleagues, store contact information, much more. I've been working for months to improve the CRM based on customer feedback, and I'm really excited to show off the new features. So let's jump right into it.
Once you access the OptiOpp CRM, the first thing that you're going to notice is this navigation section. On the left-hand side, we have the general databases, sales databases, and then on the right-hand side, we have some CRM pages, sales pages, a support page, and the support database. Now, it's important to mention that this navigation is within a synced block, which in Notion means whenever you're editing this navigation, you're also going to be editing it in other parts of the CRM so that whenever you modify it to meet your own business's needs, you don't need to go into each individual page and add that new database or page so you can easily access it in the future. Another thing to quickly point out here is the OptiOpp CRM feedback page. When you click into it, you'll come to a form that asks you what type of enhancements you're liking to see in future versions of this CRM. By getting the professional CRM, you'll have access to updates we make as Notion continues to change their software, as well as we receive feedback from our customers and continue to build the best CRM within Notion that's possible. So make sure you leave us feedback on how we can improve, and we'll be sending updates to you via email in the future. Coming back to the main page of the CRM, I'm going to scroll down, and we have a main dashboard here that allows you to see analytics for your business, has some important views, as well as allows you to quick add some records. The analytics dashboard was created with Formula 2.0 and allows you to get a glance of what are the amount of total customers you have, what are your total prospects, deal information, how many contacts you have in the system and what status they're in, what's it looking like for your projects in terms of backlog, planning in progress, and completed ones, how many tasks do you and your team members have, and then also for support, how many issues do you have open that you need to resolve, as well as how many have you completed over this month and all time. For important views, you're also going to be able to see what is your revenue for the month on which you've actually won. Then what are some deals that you still have in the pipeline that could potentially even increase your revenue more? What are some of the open issues that you have with your customers that you and your team need to resolve? And then we also have a view of your clients that have overdue invoices and have not paid you yet. As you can see, it gives you the outstanding balance and exactly which invoices are overdue. Scrolling up just a little bit more, we have the quick add section that allows you to simply just click one of these buttons and create a new account, new contact, new opportunity, and so on. This should allow you to work fast whenever you need to create new records. Now let's move on to the sales piece of this CRM, which is going to be the sales CRM. So let's click into it. Again, you can see navigation, but when you're outside of the main page in the CRM, you can collapse the navigation if you don't wish to see all these databases and pages. Here on the sales CRM page, you're gonna be able to see one this month, what are your open deals, who are your customer accounts, who are your prospect accounts, who are your prospect contacts, and who are your customer contacts. Of course, for contacts, accounts, and opportunities, we have different fields to allow you to enter their contact information, give them statuses, and other relevant info that you see in typical CRMs. Now, another part of the CRM that's going to be important for your sales team is going to be the pipeline review page. This pipeline review page is going to give you an even more in-depth analysis of how your business is doing and allow you to break it down on a rep by rep basis. This is a great page to pull up whenever you're conducting sales meetings and need to get the status of how all deals are doing. First up on this page, we have the opportunities by owner, and this is going to give you a breakdown of deals owned by each one of your reps, and you're gonna be able to see how much is in their pipeline, how much they've won, how much they've won this month, how much they've lost overall, and then how much they've lost this month in terms of deals. Then we have the opportunities by stage Kanban board, which is going to allow you to see where all of your deals are in their process. Out of the box, there are the stages of prospecting, discovery, proposal, negotiation, but you can obviously add your own stages. If you're conducting a sales meeting and you need to move one of these deals to a stage that's further along, simply click into here, then select the correct status. For this one, I'm going to move it from discovery to proposal, and you can see it move along in this Kanban board. And hopefully you get to the point where you've eventually won that deal and the status has moved to close won. But if you unfortunately lose it, you would move it to close lost. Underneath opportunities by stage, we have opportunities created as well as accounts created. And these views are sorted by the created date. So they're going to allow you to see what are the most recent deals and accounts that have been created within the CRM. There's two different views for both of these. You can have this month, which is in a gallery view. And then if we select this year and you want to see all the deals that have been created in the year, you can see that as well. And then you can see it on accounts too. Then finally, on the sales pipeline page, you're able to see the opportunities by close date in a calendar view. And if the close date needs to move around for some of these deals, you can simply drag and drop them into their correct date. And you're going to be able to look historically by going back and forth in this calendar when you're winning your deals. Now we're gonna move on to the sales clean your CRM page. And what this page does is it gives you a good place to go to find some data that might be missing for opportunities, accounts, and contacts. So for example, we have this open with close date in the past. This shows that we have a deal that has a close date in the past, but is in a open stage. And by open, it means it's closed won or closed lost. So it means that a rep is still actively working it. And of course, that means that the close date for when the deal was either lost or won should be in the future. And there's several other views like this for these databases. So just make sure you come here every once in a while and clean it out, as well as whenever you add important properties that are specific to your business, you can add views here to make sure that your team's always checking and have those data points filled. The final piece of the sales CRM is the invoice dashboard. It's going to allow you to see your overdue invoices. You're also able to see all of your invoice data in these table views with the amounts, what is their status, what is the day issued, due date, and pay date. You can also look at your invoices by issue date and be able to see the oldest ones that still don't have a status of received payment. Then you have your drafts and invoices that are recently paid, and you're able to see that sum. Now to edit these invoices to meet your needs, I have a detailed video on how to do this within the CRM. But to give a quick overview, you simply go to edit the database template. You'd input your company name, leave bill two as is to start, and then make sure you enter the payment method that you're usually sending to your customers. Once you've edited that database template, that change will reflect on invoices you're creating into the future. And before you send off invoices to your customers, simply put in the line items and their unit price, and then hit share, enter your customer's email, and then they can review it and give you payment for your product or services. Before we move on to the support piece of this CRM, I want to show you what accounts look like and how this CRM gives you a really good overview of each one of your customers and clients. So anywhere in the CRM, whether you're in the accounts database or you're in a view like this where you can click into an account, you're going to be able to see all of their deal information, contacts, projects, support cases, and all the other data associated with them in one spot. The data model of this Notion CRM is heavily inspired by Salesforce, which has accounts, or also consider your client's database, at the top of the hierarchy. And this enables you to have a really efficient system for being able to view each one of your client or prospect data just in one click. So with that being said, let's move over to the support piece of things. So we're gonna go back into the main page of the OptiOpp CRM, and I am going to select support CRM. Once you click into the support CRM, you're going to be able to see what are the open issues that haven't been resolved for your customers, as well as some issues that have been resolved in the past 7 days and the past 30 days. You also have the ability to drill down on what is the type of issue, and you can add your own options here, but I've added some generic ones for you. So billing, product, and feedback. And then, for example, if we've selected billing, you'd want to choose one of these billing subtypes. So we have a billing dispute, payment issue, or a billing inquiry. What you can do with the support CRM is connect this database to a form where your customers can then submit issues. And that data is then transferred over to Notion. You can use something like Tally Forms that has a direct integration, or if you're already using some sort of form that doesn't have a native integration with Notion, you can use Zapier or Make to connect the data. Whenever a new case is created, it automatically timestamps this open date so you can see what time it first popped up in your system. And then there's this field close date, which has an automation tied to it. So whenever we resolve this case, I'm going to put it to closed. You can see it's moved to the closed past 7 days. You can see it's been a while since I played around with this data because it's giving me a turnaround time of 279 hours. If I was to go in here and make this a more realistic date, let's move it to January 27th at 1:42 p.m. It then gives you that turnaround time of 2 hours and 42 minutes. So this will allow you to, over time, look at all of your cases, figure out which ones are taking longer, and figure out better solutions to solve issues faster. Next up, we have the personal workspace, which is going to allow you and all of your employees to have one spot to go to view all of their data that is within the CRM. They're able to quickly see all the accounts that they own, the opportunities that they own, support cases that are in their name that they need to resolve, their projects and tasks, and contacts that they own too. Now, every person likes to work in different ways or has a different role. So if you ever need to create specific personal workspaces for each one of your employees, you can simply just duplicate this page and then modify it to meet their own needs. But the key here is that each one of these databases is filtered down on me. So whoever is viewing that data from their user account that they're logged in within Notion, they're only going to see the data that they own in the CRM. The final piece that I want to showcase to you, but might be the most important, is the CRM Wiki. The CRM Wiki acts as documentation for you to be able to better understand how to use the CRM. I'm just glancing over some of these features, and obviously you need a more in-depth understanding of how to use each of these things together to successfully use this for your business. For each one of the databases, I've gone ahead and created detailed video demonstrations on how to use them. I've also added some tutorial videos that are important for uploading data and other relevant things that are important to know whenever using Notion for businesses. And I've also included a video on Notion wikis and why your team shouldn't only just use this to learn how to use this CRM in the initial stages, but also use it to store all of your unique processes so that each employee has a centralized space to go to know how to be as productive as possible. With all that's provided in this Notion CRM, you'll have everything you'll need to successfully operate and track your business's success. Don't be afraid to leave us feedback so we can continue to build the best CRM in Notion. And also know that there is a free version of this CRM available that is a bare bones replica of the Salesforce data model. All of the modifications added onto the free version took many hours to put together, and I think you'll find the cost of upgrading to be more than worth it. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more Notion templates just like this and tips and tutorials on how to take your business's use of Notion to new heights. See you in the next video.